Hello everybody, in this video I would like to show you how to create lists of numbers and objects in GeoGebra. The command that we are going to use is the sequence command, with which we can create lists of integer numbers, fractions or decimal numbers. Not only that, we can also manipulate those lists and do operations with them like subtraction, addition, multiplication and division. We can also create sequences of objects like points, functions, or polygons, for example. The sequence commands requires a few parameters to input, and in the following, I will show you a few examples of how to work with this command. So here I have opened GeoGebra Classic 5, but you can use GeoGebra 6 or the online version. The first example I want to show you is just a sequence of numbers from 1 to 5 as a list. So the basic way to type this is just using the curly brackets as this example, and then hit enter and we obtain our list of numbers. We can use the sequence command by just introducing the n value. That will be the first option, and we will get the same sequence. We can use the second option, which is star value 1 and n value 5. And the last option is just to type 1 dot 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 5. And then we have the same list as we did in the beginning. So the only problem is if I want to increase the number of elements in my list number 1, then I need to input each one of those numbers manually. With the sequence command, I just need to change the n value and I will increase the number of elements in on my lists, as you can see here. And I can add as many elements as I want. Now with these examples, I can just create simple sequences of numbers starting at 1 with an increment of 1. Now let me get rid of all these lists and let's use the other options for the sequence command, so we can create different kind of sequences of numbers. In the input box, we type sequence and we select this, the expression variable star value and value. The expression is going to be 2k plus 1, the variable k. I can use another letter for the variable, for example, it could be I. And then the star value is going to be 0. And the n value is going to be 10. And there we go, we have the odd numbers on my sequence. I can increase the number of elements by just changing the n value to 20. And there we go. If I want to know the length of this list, I type length of L1. And there we go, we have 21 elements. I can also select the elements of this list by using the command element. Element of the list and the position, for example, number 1, that is 1. If I choose the position 5, that is going to be 9. And if I choose the position, for example, 8, that is going to be 15. I can also type, instead of using the element command, I can just type L1 brackets 1, for example, and that is number 1. And I can change that to, for example, 9, it's going to be 17, or 8, which is the number 15. And there we go. We have two possible options to select elements from a list. It could be the element command or just type the L1 brackets and the element that we want of my list. Now let's create another list with the command 1.21. And here I have a simple list from 1 to 21 because that is the number of elements. We can check that is the length of the L2 that is equal to 21. Now both lists have the same number of elements, so I can make operations with these two different lists. For example, I can type L1 plus L2 and then I get the sum of the each one of those elements in the list 1 and 2. I can type L1 minus L2 and I get the subtraction, and I can type L1 times L2, the multiplication, and L1 divided by L2, which is the division. And we can do all these operations. We can do also powers, but you can try that by yourself. Now by default, the sequence has an increment of 1 for the expression, the variable, the star value, and the n value. I can change that by introducing another number at the very end of my sequence command. In this case, I'm going to choose now number 2. So you can see that my list has changed, and also the number of elements in my list is less. And I still can select the elements of those lists using the element command or the L1 brackets. And notice that list number 2 has 21 values. I need to change that, otherwise the operations between these two lists won't be defined, as you can appreciate here. So if I modify this second list L2 to 11, then you can see now the operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division are defined. So the operations with lists, all lists must have the same number of elements. Now let's get rid of all these lists here, and instead of defining sequences of numbers, now we're going to define sequences of objects in GeoGebra. Now let's begin with a very basic example. Let's type a sequence, and we're going to choose the expression, variable, start value, and end value. The expression is going to be a point, so we open brackets, k, 1, the variable is going to be k, the start value is -3, end value is going to be 3, and we're going to change the increment to 0.5 instead of 1 by default. So there we go, we have a list of points that are defined on my graphics view. And now, instead of having points, we can have circles, for example, and we can modify this command by just introducing the tool circle. And for that, I'm going to need the point. The point is going to be k, 1, and the radius is just going to be, let's type 1 over k just to see what happens. And there we go. Now notice that some points and some circles are not going to be defined, and that is because of the interval where the variable k is going to be defined. So let's define it between 1 and 10 so we can have well-defined elements on my list. And there we go, we have the sequence of circles which radii are decreasing with respect of the variable k. Now I can change that sequence. So for example, instead of looking at my circles to be parallel to the x-axis, I can change that to be parallel to the y-axis, as you can see here. And also I can put it at the center of the y-axis. Super easy. Now let's get rid of this sequence and let's create another sequence, but now we are going to define functions like x to the power of k. K is my variable, and start value at 0 and value at 20 with an increment of 1 by default. And notice we have here a sequence of polynomial, and let's see if we can define another sequence of functions. So let's use the expression, and here I'm going to type the let's type k times sine of x, and the variable is going to be k, the star value I'm going to start -2 and value 2 with an increment of 0.2. and there we go, we obtain a sequence of trigonometric functions, and this pattern looks pretty cool. Now let's see if we can make operations with them. Let's just try to type L1 plus L2 and see what happens. So we type L1 plus L2, and there we go. Ah, we were pretty lucky. Apparently they both have the same number of elements, and we can check that by just using the command length. So let's type length of L1, 21, and then length of L2, and we get 21. There we go, we have the same number of elements, and therefore we can make operations with these two lists of functions. These two sequences of functions, they are of the same kind, so that's why we can operate with them. So we're not limited only to operating with sequences of numbers or lists of numbers in GeoGebra. Okay, now let's see another example using polygons. And first we remove the previous list, and we're going to type sequence, choose expression. I'm going to use the polygon command, and it's going to be regular, so I'm going to need 2 points and the final value, which is going to be the number of sides on my regular polygon, and that is going to be my variable k. And here k is going to start at 3 with n value of 10. And there we go, we obtain this beautiful pattern of regular polygons. Now I can increase the number of elements on my list just by changing the last number of my sequence. So let's do that. Let's, instead of using 10, let's put 20. And there we go. You can appreciate this beautiful, beautiful pattern with regular polygons. Now, so far we have made a one-dimensional arrays or list. So let's see what happens if we combine two times the command sequence. Let's type sequence and sequence, and we're going to type some points, and the point is going to be j comma k. The k runs from minus 4 to 4. Actually, we have to change that k. Instead of k, it has to be j. That is going to be my row, and the column is going to be k, that runs from minus 4 to 4 with an increment of 1. And there we go. When we combine the sequence command two times, we obtain a two-dimensional array that is no longer a list, it's a matrix, and that's why we have this array of points on my graphics view. Now we can access this array of points by using again the element command, but instead of using the list, I'm going to choose the matrix with row and column. So m1, for example, and here the element 1,1, that is going to be that point at the corner, and if I change that to 2,1, that is going to be the next row in my matrix. Now let's see what else we can do with this. So we can define, for example, circles, and we are going to choose a circle here of point and radius. The point is going to be the element of my matrix M1, so I'm going to type element of my matrix, the matrix is M1, the row is J, the column K, and then the radius is going to be 0.5, and now the row J runs from minus 4 to 4. Wait a second, no, that's incorrect. It should be from 1,9. That is going to be the number of elements of my row, and the K runs from 1 to 9. And there we go, we have the new array, but now with circles using the points of my matrix M1. We can do a similar example now, but I'm going to show you here with the 3D graphics view. Instead of using the element command, I'm going to use the different way to select elements of my matrix. So let's define first the points as we did before. So I have a double sequence of j, k. The j and k, they run from minus 4 to 4. And there we go, we have my array of points. Now I'm going to draw a double sequence, that is a matrix of circles, so I had to type the double sequence, and here in my expression I type circle of point and radius, and now I'm going to choose M1 brackets, and that is going to be j comma k, and the radius is going to be 0.5. This is just a similar example. Instead of using the element command, I'm going to use M1 brackets j comma k, and then we just define all the variables within the same range, and you can appreciate the array of circles, but now in three dimensions and using the expression M1 brackets j comma k. Now we can change that. Instead of using circles, I can, use spheres. So let's modify that, that's M2. So I'm gonna delete it. I'm gonna just type it again. So I need a double sequence. And in the expression, what I need to do is to type, instead of circle, I need to type, for example, sphere. here. Let's select that. There we go. Select sphere, and then I need the point. The point is going to be in the M1 matrix. I open the brackets, so a j comma k, the radius, and let's choose 0.25. The variable is just j from 1 to 9, and the k that runs from 1 to 9. And there we go, we have a two-dimensional array, but now of spheres that we can appreciate in the 3D graphics view. And now, just to finalize with these examples, to make it a little bit more harder, and we are going to define and to introduce another sequence command. So we're going to use the sequence command three times so we can create a three-dimensional array of points and then a three-dimensional array of spheres. And this is super easy. We just need to introduce the other sequence command with the other component, which will be the set component. Here we can type, for example, ijk, with the ijk being the variables that run from minus 4 to 4, so we obtain this three-dimensional array of points. And if we want to just introduce a three-dimensional array of spheres, we combine three times the sequence command. And we, for example, type the sphere of point. The point is going to be on the L1. This is the three-dimensional array of the elements ijk with radius 0.25, and the variables again is I, j, and k. And that's it. We obtained our three-dimensional array of spheres in GeoGebra. Alright, so we covered a few examples using the sequence command with different input values, from basic to a little bit more complicated examples. I will leave a link in the description with the GeoGebra script so you can play around with these examples and make a few changes, and also maybe use other GeoGebra commands. In combination with other commands, we can create amazing constructions. Like these ones, for example. Well, the possibilities are endless if we also introduce color. Well, thank you for watching. If you would like to see more videos like this, let me know in the comments. Bye bye.